I've been traveling around for about 3 months in this country, and it's very interesting to notice that practically every city or town, regardless of the size, there's always somebody in the process of putting on a Gilbert and Sullivan opera. In which case, it seems a pity that there weren't a few more of them that were a little more up to date. So I've been studying the matter, and I have evolved a formula for writing your own Gilbert and Sullivan. And it's a sort of vitamin pill that contains all the necessary ingredients. And so long as you use this formula, you can put your opera where you like. This particular example is located in New York City. As you know, you always have to start with a homogeneous chorus. Now, I know a lot of people are going to say that isn't homogeneous, that's homogeneous. But that isn't what I mean. I mean homogeneous as in milk. All the characters are the same. They're either all Japanese or all pirates or all something or other. In this case, they are all the New York upper crust. This is the chorus hat. The great 400. If you want to know who we are, we put on airs because our forefathers came over with the Mayflower. And it's very, very snappy if your mammy or your pappy is descended from the Mayflower. We're in the social register. All lower class types we shun. But to keep our niche, we must stay very rich, because we'll be thrown out when we've none. And it's very, very funny when you've lots and lots of money to be horrible to those with none. Be horrible to those with none. This story is as follows, which is a typical one. Parnassus Q. Vanderfeller has lost all his money and he's liable to be thrown out of the social register unless he gets some pretty quickly. Well, of course, he's far too aristocratic to work, so all that is left to him is to marry his only daughter, Pneumonia Vanderfeller, to a rich man. Well, Pneumonia is in love with a mere nobody called John Smith. So, of course, she's very upset. She is the British piercing type soprano that is always connected with these operations. She's very sweet. Treacherous heart that led me astray, filling my life with consternation. My dear papa, how can I betray by marrying a man below my station? Oh, happy I'd be to wed him, I know, if I weren't so grand and he weren't so low. I'd marry him still and try to ignore his lowly estate if he were not so. Thank you. The man, John Smith, that she is in love with is, of course, the tenor. Now, it's absolutely obligatory that the tenor sing an aria in 6/8 time in a Gilbert and Sullivan opera, usually accompanying himself upon the guitar, the mandolin, or some such instrument. If you want to woo a fair maid, you must concentrate on her papa. If he doesn't like you, your chances are not worth a cent. Things would be so different if they were not as they are. If I were more demanding or she were less obedient. Too much of this, too little of that, so I may as well blow. Things would be so different if they were not as they are. If I weren't so handsome or I just got a little more dough. Vodio-dough, just a little more dough. Oh, are it so? The man she is going to be made to marry is Clodbelly Bunyan, the rich tycoon. He is the little man that prances around and sings the patter song. And here, assisted by the chorus, he tells how he became the rich tycoon. Had a very rudimentary education. My success is due entirely to my great determination. Once I nearly went to prison for a shady operation, but I undermined the jury and they changed their tune. I started as a gangster with a power so despotic the police became dogmatic and the going too chaotic that I made a lot of money on a very nice narcotic. I'm that fabulous phenomenon, the great tycoon. His amazing generosity is really quite hysterical. This extroverted psychopath, the great tycoon. I was underprivileged when young and suffered from starvation. I decided to be rich so I could eat till satiation. Now my duodenal ulcers reach the point of perforation, and all I get is bismuth and a darn great spoon. I got mixed up in politics and found it quite delectable. I did a lot of chiseling in manners undetectable, but now I'm so conspicuous I'm forced to be respectable. It's really very dull to be a rich tycoon. His political connections have become so widely publicized he's forced to be respectable, a poor tycoon. This character always does a little dance and an encore, whether you want him to or not. So I guess we may as well have it. To found a Bunyan dynasty, a very great pomposity, pneumonia shall wed me, though she finds me a monstrosity, and has a feeling for me of the wildest animosity. The nuptials will be solemnized this afternoon. But all these machinations leave a feeling of futility. My coronary thrombosis is affecting my ability. Increasing adiposity has ruined my virility. I am a very miserable rich tycoon. His sniveling and driveling is altogether risible. This miserable drizzle was a rich tycoon. Now the wedding guests are all assembled, and to entertain them, there comes on the madrigal. Now this is a mixed quartet. You will have to be indulgent with me in this one because my quartet singing isn't as good as it used to be. See the maid of matchless beauty on the ground, her eyes she's keeping. Sadly, sadly is she weeping. Masterpiece of filial duty, weep not, gentle Toto.
sunny, should all be sunny. Claude Belly has lots of money.
What if from your love you've parted?
If you've money, who wants love?
Fa la 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 la.
Fa la 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 la.
Fa la 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 la. Fa la 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 la.
Fa la 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 la.
Fa la 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 la.
The knot is just about to be tied when who should come in but Dandelion. She is the large, fat contralto with a voice like a foghorn that you have to have in these productions. She is currently the Vanderfeller's publicity woman. But she stops the wedding because she says she has a confession to make, assisted by the chorus.
Hold my crime, I must confess. A black disgrace. What will the Vandal fellows think of me? They paid me money to tout their name abroad. When they find out I was a nurse in the hospital maternity ward. The newborn babes they trusted to my care, all alike, bright red, no teeth, no hair. But one I knew, 'twas little baby Bunyan. He'd a birthmark here, just like a Spanish onion. He'd a birthmark there, beside a Spanish onion. I put each babe into an empty cot, but to label them I quite forgot. They got all mixed up, but I kept the whole thing dark. But I lost the babe that had the onion mark. Woo! She lost the babe that had the onion mark. So even if I land in dire disgrace, Pneumonia's wedding shall not now take place. For he who must be her future husband dear has got an onion mark behind his ear.
Oh, he's got an onion mark behind his ear.
Well, naturally, they find that John Smith has an onion mark behind his ear. Therefore, he is really Claude Belly Bunyan. And the marriage could go on as arranged. And the little fellow that sings the patter song is always made to marry the great big contralto. Then you have the little bit where everybody sings the sort of chorale business and the free-for-all at the end.
I am the one, I have an onion mark behind my ear.
My ecstasy soon will be my lovely husband, dear.
This marriage would have been a strain. I'm glad that I am free again. I really am delighted as can be.
I hope he'll be delighted still when he finds it traditional that in the end he has to marry, ha-ha, me. Now, girls and boys, just raise the voice. The words don't matter now, just make a noise. And you, know what to do. Go home and write a comic opera too.
Then you salute the flag.
You'll need a hand.
handsome young couple whose voices are supple and charming, if just a bit sickly. A chorus to prance through the same kind of dance and do everything terribly quickly. You'll need a small skinny guy who's amazingly spry, with a voice like a vegetable grater. A tremendous old crone with a strange vocal tone, like our mouth is all full of potato. These operas have got an identical plot, so the narrative doesn't much matter. But it's great to poke fun at most everyone with your typical topical patter. So if you're psychotic or rather neurotic, or if you've a notion you're far too emotional, if you've a pain or a feeling, a strain, get it out of your system by writing a popular operette. An